हेलो स्टूडेंट, दिस इज अनदर वीडियो इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस एन इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक. टॉपिक इज हाउ टू राइट अ जजमेंट. जजमेंट फॉर व्हाट पर्पस? इफ यू वांट टू बिकम अ जज, राइट? द जजमेंट राइटिंग इज एन स्किल विच इज टू बी अ डेवलप्ड स्किल फॉर द पर्पस ऑफ राइटिंग जजमेंट. When we talk about the judgment writing, it is a skill to be maintained when especially you are talking about MP Judicial Services, Chhattisgarh Judicial Services. In states mein, mains mein bhi aapko judgments likhna hota hai. Now the question is, how you are going to write a perfect judgment by which you are attaining a very good decent marks? Now let me make it very clear. When we talk about judgment writing, in case of judgment writing, there is a category of two classes. One is that when we are talking about civil matters, if you want to write a good judgment in civil matters, the method is something different. When we talk about the judgment in the criminal matters, it is something we have to adopt a different approach. Why I am saying so? Suppose when we talk about the judgment writing in the civil matters, first of all, we have to go through what kinds of legislation you need to have the understanding. Suppose for civil matters, आपका सिविल प्रोसीजर कोड विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट लेजिस्लेशन विच टॉक्स अबाउट द प्रोसीजर. इंडियन एविडेंस एक्ट 1872 विच टॉक्स अबाउट हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू अप्रिशिएट द एविडेंसेस एंड अदर प्रोविजंस लाइक अदर फैमिली लॉज एंड अदर सिविल लॉज सच एज कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, पार्टनरशिप, ट्रांसफर ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी एक्ट एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. सो दीज आर द ग्रुप ऑफ लेजिस्लेशन विच नीड्स टू बी प्रिपेयर्ड फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ सिविल जजमेंट राइटिंग. Now just move toward criminal matters. If you want to write a good judgment in the criminal matters, you will have to go through, especially you should have the commands over, that is Indian Penal Code, which is 1860. Another is that is Criminal Procedure Code, which is a plain simple procedure in terms of this penal matters. And now another legislation which is common in the both matters, in civil and criminal, that is Indian Evidence Act. Now I just come to the points which I am discussing here. Wherever you are going to read in a particular judgment, I can say you one thing. कि judgment writing को पढ़कर आपको वो feel आना चाहिए that all of the things, all of the important things have been addressed. For example, nobody can forget the writing of judgment, especially when we talk about Honorable Justice Deepak Mishra, who has been the then Chief Justice of India. Who wrote the judgment having adoption of so many ornamental languages, English literature, any foreign language also. So his skill of writing the judgment is very popular in present scenario also. But actually we are talking about our competitive examination, so we don't need to go through about these ornamental languages. We will have to simply focus ki jo aap judgment likh rahe ho for the purpose of examination, usme aap kaise achhe marks gain kar sakte ho. Suppose when we talk about civil matters judgment writing, वो कौन से स्टेजेस हैं जिनको आपको करना होता है. सो लेट मी मेक इट वेरी क्लियर टू यू दैट इन केस ऑफ सिविल मैटर्स, अगर आपको किसी सिविल मैटर को लेके कोई स्टोरी दिया हुआ है और आपसे एग्जामिनेशन में पूछा गया है कि आप इसमें एक जजमेंट राइटिंग कर लो, राइट? सो व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर्स? तो सिविल केसेस में आपको जो जजमेंट लिखना होता है उसमें नंबर फर्स्ट दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन. इंट्रोडक्शन मीन्स टू से सपोज दैट इफ यू आर राइटिंग अबाउट एनी पर्टिकुलर इश्यूज, तो आपको एग्जामिनेशन में पूरा एक कंटेंट उन्होंने दे रखा है, दैट इज कॉल्ड फैक्ट स्टोरी. ओके, इस फैक्ट स्टोरी में आपको करना क्या है, यू विल हैव टू टेक ओनली ब्रीफ स्टोरी ऑफ दिस होल स्टोरी, जो कि आप इंट्रोडक्शन में डाल सकते हो. आप बता सकते हो कि इस पूरे जो पूरी स्टोरी है इसमें कौन कौन सी वो इंपॉर्टेंट इश्यूज है जिसको आप एड्रेस करोगे. Then another thing is that when you have said that introduction, you will have to go toward that is point of determination. Point of determination, which is to be set at framing of issues, right? So another stage is framing of issues. आप judgment लिखते समय जो सबसे important stage होता है आपके judgment में civil matters में वो होता है you will have to frame issues. And what I'm talking about the framing of issues means to say, इस सारे स्टोरी में सारा स्टोरी इंपॉर्टेंट नहीं है. मैटर ऑफ कंसिडरेशन आर देयर, देयर आर इशू नंबर वन, इशू नंबर टू. सो देयर आर ओनली सम इशूज विच नीड्स टू बी एड्रेस्ड फॉर द पर्पज ऑफ रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ द मैटर. तो फ्रेमिंग ऑफ इशूज इज इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड द पॉइंट ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन इज टू बी सेट टू द दिस वन. चाहे आप पॉइंट ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन को, तो क्रिमिनल मैटर्स में आप पॉइंट ऑफ डिटर्मिनेशन बोलोगे, जबकि सिविल मैटर्स में आप इश्यू फ्रेमिंग करते हो. देन वी टॉक अबाउट दैट इज एप्रिशिएशन ऑफ एविडेंस. एप्रिशिएशन ऑफ एविडेंस इट मीन्स टू से वंस यू हैव ऑलरेडी डिसाइडेड व्हाट आर द इम्पोर्टेंट इश्यूज इन द मैटर, आपको फिर करना होता है कि अब आप एप्रिशिएट करो. मीन्स टू से जो भी आपकी जो पार्टीज हैं, जो प्लेंटिफ और डिफेंडेंट ने जो भी इश्यूज के बाद जो भी आपको एविडेंस दिए हैं थ्रू रिटन स्टेटमेंट, थ्रू एडमिशन, थ्रू अपीयरिंग इन द कोर्ट ऑफ लॉ, ऑल ऑफ द थिंग्स टू बी टेकन टूगेदर एंड देन ट्राई टू एप्रिशिएट द वैल्यू ऑफ दीज एविडेंसेज. Once you have decided that these are the particular issues, these are the particular evidences, you will have to come to the conclusion. So as soon as you have gone through the appreciation of evidence, another stage is that you will have to apply law. Okay, so it means that apply of legislation. इसका मतलब जैसे आपके पास evidences आ जाते हैं, you will have to go through all these laws which are applicable in that particular matter. For example, if there is any relevance of a particular section of Indian Evidence Act, is the admission is relevant, anything else, section 7, 8, 9, 10, anything else, your registration act ka koi provision hai, your specific relief act ka koi provision hai, wo jo particular laws hai, aap usko apply karo and try to focus on that whether this is suitable legislation by which you are going to resolve the issue. So, how many things have been taken into consideration? You have taken introduction, brief story of the facts. You have gone through the issues framing. It means you have framed the issues. Once you have framed the issues, you have gone through the appreciation of evidences, taking all these laws which are applicable in that matter, and finally you will have to conclude the matter. So conclusion is something which is very important in the civil matters as well as in criminal matters. In the conclusion, you will have to decide what has been determined on the basis of legislation, on the basis of evidences produced, and the basis of all of the matters into consideration by the court of law. So finally, you will have to conclude the matter. Now the question is, as in the civil matters, similarly, criminal matters. In criminal matters, maybe, jo bhi case story di hai, either through FIR, either through complaint, you will have to go through the story behind that. You will have to take out what are the important points for determination, not the whole story. Second stage is to make the point of determination. As far as you have already determined the point of determination in a very brief or short and crisp way, then try to focus on what kind of law you are going to apply. So once you have decided, okay, these are the legislation, these are the important landmark recent cases which are to be introduced, which are to be induced here to resolve the matter, you will have to put all these things together. After that, on the basis of all the evidence, case laws, legislation, you will have to make determination. This means to say conclusion. So if you find that the person is convicted for the particular offense, you will have to say clearly for that particular punishment, the amount of punishment, the amount of fine. Okay, if you are saying that the person is to be acquitted because there are no sufficient evidences, then you will have to make it very clearly that the person is acquitted. So these are the basic rules whenever you are going to write the judgment. In conclude, I want to say some five important points. Number first, whenever you are going to write a good judgment for the examination purpose, read the fact story very carefully. Because unless and until you are reading the story carefully, it might be possible you are going to lose, you are going to avoid any particular important proviso which is applicable in that problem in which you can invoke a particular section here. So, agar aapne usko carefully read kiya hai, then you will become capable to determine what kind of issues are there, on what points you will have to apply your mind, what are the irrelevant points which you need to avoid. That is an important thing. Second thing is that when you have read it very carefully, please remember, if you have ascertained some point of issues or the determination, you will have to justify, you will have to give your opinion, your subjectivity on each and every point. So if there are two, three issues are there in your judgment writing, you will have to demarcate in different paras what kind of resolution you are giving in that para. So, har ek point of determination ko properly address karo. Now, application of law is very important. If you are going to appreciate the evidences, you will have to go through. Agar aapko dying declaration pe aap likh rahe ho, agar aapko lag raha hai ki this statement is relevant under DD, So you will have to put the landmark judgment on that basis you are saying that it is relevant or not. So what kind of evidence you are saying that you are justifying that, okay, we are admitting these kinds of fact, I am going to put my conclusion on that. So you will have to substantiate it. So these are the third point. Now fourth point is, please remember, your language should be short, crisp and clear. Don't use rhetoric language, ornamental language to extend your sentences, because the important thing is that whenever a plain reading is judgment is there, it must be addressed what kind of solution, what kind of resolution you are giving to the person. That is something which is crisp, clear, short, you know, don't, without using this ornamental language. And the last point is that you need to conclude your judgment with the clarity, with the clarity of sufficiency especially. कि अगर examiner आपका conclusion देखे तो वो realize कर ले that you have put your legal approach and you finally concluded in that matter without any if and but. There should be finality on that opinion. This is all art I'm talking about. So I hope you have some kind of ideas in writing the judgment. We will have some more clarification on the writing of judgment in our next videos. Thank you so much for watching.